So we have N5J in Palmyra on 20 meters this morning. Nice strong signal. And so we are calling him using the Super Hound mode of FT8. See, we're running about 400 watts out to my two-element hex beam at the moment. N5J is coming in at plus 7. He's busy. Don't have him yet. Right now it's 10:53 UTC on Saturday, the 9th of August. Early morning here in the United States. Beautiful signal on 20 meters. Working Europeans. My two-element hex beam pointed at 262 degrees short path. Plus 8 dBm signal coming in from it. Okay, there he's working a W1. Thank you. Oops, I dropped out. You'll see the N3FJP logging software in the upper right-hand monitor, and my radio and amplifier panels there in the left monitor, the Flex Maestro C down here. And then the third monitor that's up high, you can't see directly, but we can look at it here, is WSJTX, the improved version from UVA. What we're looking for is a red bar to come across the software here that will say that we were received by them. Even stronger now, plus 9. It's my understanding in this super foxhound mode that they can work up to 9 stations at a time. Looks like he's working about 5 or 6 stations at a time. But the throughput rate is actually faster than CW, at least it was yesterday. So, still no red to connect bar. Now running about 500 watts, about 51 degrees is what my amplifier will heat up to at the moment, 51 degrees Celsius. Theoretically, I guess we're in a queue, and when our turn comes around, then we'll get a connect signal back from them. This is the version 2.7.1 improved of the software. It's a fork of the WSJTX done by a German ham, Uwe. It's on his SourceForge page. Very strong signal, plus 9 coming from Palmyra. I bet they are just swamped with signals coming into them. I may try changing my transmit frequency here in the spectrum. Oops, I dropped that. If I can hear the other stations calling, I know that's not a good thing. So just by way of review, the radio is a Flex 6600 and going to an RF Kit S solid-state amplifier running at about 500 watts going into a two-element K4 KIO hex beam pointed toward Palmyra. He's running about six or seven stations in each go. Wow, he's up to plus 11 now. Amazing. Changing my transmit frequency around a little bit to see if I can get away from other stations. But I have no idea what that spectrum is like. But it's more centered up in the spectrum where I have him. Wow, we got up to plus 13. That's huge. Here's what it looks like on my Maestro C. And there I'm transmitting. Still not yet. I think you just gotta be patient. only four stations on that go. Only three stations on that go. Whoops, see, dropped out of transmit. It'll do that. So it is early morning here in the United States in the Eastern time zone. I have my coffee and we're just watching the paint dry, so to speak, here with FT8 Super Hound mode, Super Fox Super Hound. I'm the hound. They're the fox. Oh, where'd they go? Oh, there they are. And now they're calling CQ. Wow. What happened? They're so strong in here, you would think that they would hear me. But you don't know what's going on at their end. All right, some foreland stateside calls. All right, well, they're working a bunch of stations on this go over, and that's good. Eight of them. Some Japanese. Ooh, I just bumped it. It's called bumping the tuning knob. Not a good thing to do. But it's early. Good morning. Some people have likened this FT8 mode to watching paint dry. But we're getting good decodes, good signal strength, plus 9 from them. Running about 400 to 500 watts toward them. Should be able to make the trip. I think they're just so darn busy. It was interesting, there was only one spot that came in early this morning announcing this, but I was right on it. You can see here on the Maestro the spectrum of the RF with the multi-tone mode of the Super Fox. Very strong here. This is the screen that counts. This is WSJTX. Still looking for a red bar to appear that he's coming back to me. Not yet. Dropped out. The time you're seeing there is UTC. Today is the 9th of August. about 13 watts out of the Flex 6600 radio going into the RF kit amplifier, which is amplifying it up to about 500 watts RF output. I got plenty of nothing, and nothing's plenty for me. I did work them yesterday on 12 meters. Patience is a virtue. Not sure why, but it will drop out of transmit even before the watchdog timer times out, so... This is experimental software also, so we have to keep that in mind. So 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Looks like 9 stations. So that's the max. I'm wondering, it's saying, indicating 772, center should be 1500. I wonder if I'm tuned up. I was trying to keep it centered in the passband. I think I'm too low now. Yes, not even decoding. That's the thing with the new mode. We're still all learning how to use it and how it works and what's right and what's not. So see, it went back down to 1490. That's interesting. I don't know why it did that. Probably shouldn't tune it while I'm transmitting, but... See, it went back down to 1490. That's wild. Oh, yay! He came back! There's the red bar I've been looking for. A minus 3 signal to him, that's fine. And hopefully we'll get a second bar coming back here with an RR73, and that constitutes a valid contact. Came back again, minus 3. Oh, still No RR73. What's going on here? There it is! Woohoo! So, there is an FT8 contact in the Super Fox Super Hound mode. Like watching paint dry, I know, but anyway. Thanks for watching, 73.